with your live Pinpoint Doppler 12 Futurecast.
Well, a lot of weather to cover over the next several hours. We've had some sporadic reports of power outages from National Grid. Nothing very impressive, about 500 outages. And that's pretty much the situation for this evening. If there's any kind of power line or tree damage, it'll be very localized and scattered. It shouldn't be widespread, but the potential is there. We'll start with the Live Pinpoint Doppler 12 radar. We've had periods of rain, obviously, working in. At times it's heavy, other times it's very light. I want to draw your attention to this area, the solid area of yellow and orange across the Connecticut River Valley. Not only is that very heavy rain, but it also represents where the core of the strongest winds are. So within this area, the potential for 40 to 50 mile per hour gusts exists. We've had some reports of tree and power line damage in the Hartford area as this tracks off to the east and northeast. So a bit of a lull for now, but the potential for stronger wind down the road in a couple of hours. So the wind and the rain for early tonight, drier air working in later on. And then after that, we're going to be setting up for a colder weather pattern, which starts tomorrow, and it may extend for many days to come. We'll show you that in the 7-day Futurecast. Some light rain in Providence right now. South-southeast wind at 21 sustained. We've had gusts as high as 40. The humidity on the high side right now at 94%. As expected, very mild air today. Temperatures mid and upper 50s, so kind of a spring-like storm system. Not quite 60 in Groton, Westerly, and Block Island, but close to it in the upper 50. So the high wind advisory for the areas in blue until 10 o'clock this evening. Gusts between 45 and 55 miles per hour. But keep in mind, these gusts are just that. They're brief bursts of strong wind. And again, they're very localized, where one town could get a 50-mile-an-hour gust, while the next town over, the wind's only blowing at 20 miles per hour. So it's that kind of a situation. These are the sustained winds right now coming in from the southeast. In other words, consistently blowing at these speeds of about 25 to 30 miles per hour. And the gusts have been ranging up to 40 miles per hour. Now, this is just a snapshot. In other words, the gusts within the last hour, more than likely stronger gusts are on the way next couple of hours. So the strongest winds now till about 9 o'clock in the evening. Of course, the wind will die down last along southeastern Massachusetts. Southeast gales between 45 and 55, and sporadic or isolated tree limb and power line damage is possible, considering they've had that nearby in Hartford, Connecticut this evening. And you see that solid line right in there. It's very thin. It'll be passing through shortly. Look at the blue back here through Pennsylvania. That's actually snow. So behind this very strong cold front right in here, responsible for the rain and wind, it's actually a lot colder. In fact, I can show you the temperatures. All of this blue represents noticeably colder air across the Great Lakes. This little sliver of green along the East Coast is the mild air. So we'll keep that for a few more hours. Then this colder reservoir of air will take over tomorrow and extend right through the weekend. So the rain and wind continues this evening, gusting to 50 at 7 o'clock, gusting to 40 at 9 o'clock, and then gusting to 30 by 11 o'clock in the evening, temps in the 50s. Then it clears out overnight. The winds come down. Temperatures drop off as well in the lower 40s. We're back to sunshine, cool and drier tomorrow morning, 38 to 43. And during the afternoon, much better, though noticeably cooler with mostly sunny skies. High temperatures around 45 to 46 degrees for the afternoon high. Futurecast starts at 10 o'clock this evening. That area of yellow and orange, that's the core of heavy rain and wind at 10 o'clock. And notice it races offshore and the drier air works in thereafter. 7-day Futurecast shows dry but colder weather for both tomorrow and Friday. Talk about chilly beginning Saturday and extending into probably all of next week. Some of the coldest air of the autumn season. Daytime highs upper 30s and nights only 20 to 25 degrees. In fact, some of our long-range computers are indicating perhaps the next couple of weeks temperatures running well below average as at least the winter chill starts to set in. As far as the core of strong wind, you can track it on WPRI.com. I would say now till about 8 o'clock in the evening, some brief bursts of some pretty strong wind, which at times can take down tree limbs and power lines, so be careful.
So if you don't have to go anywhere, just stay home.
Stay home and
watch you at 6 o'clock. Coming up on Eyewitness News Live at 5, an emotional homecoming.